No one knew about earthquake risks when industry first eyed Portland's waterfront in the early 1900s.
If you look at the old historic maps, you can see that Giles Lake was here, and you can see old photos where the river came into this area, and then they filled it.
Oil and gas companies quickly laid claim to the new land and similar lands up and down the Willamette, eventually building an entire energy complex on dredge spoils. Some of the tanks you see today are nearly 100 years old, and they're still in use. During a big earthquake, humus as a soil propping the tanks up could turn to pudding through something called liquefaction.
You need three ingredients for liquefaction. You need earthquake shaking, loose sandy soils, and those soils need to be under the water table. We went on all the facilities and I went and tested it, but there was a lot of this same type of soil under all of the tank farms.
Much of the damage sustained during earthquakes in Chile, New Zealand, and Japan was caused by liquefaction. With just a few minutes of shaking, streets warped, homes toppled, and docks and ports sunk. In places, liquefaction brought down entire city blocks. But what if it happens under tanks filled with millions of gallons of fuel?
The risk here is extreme. Within 10, 20 seconds, the sand will turn into a thick, sandy soup. The slope that we're looking at will start moving out towards the water. The tanks will start to tilt and start moving out in the direction the ground is moving.